Hi everyone. In the last video, we have discussed what is an array and why we have to learn arrays, and then properties like length and few methods like for each, and to do the manipulations we have learned push, pop, shift, unshift and fill, right? And also we have learned what is concatenation and join in arrays, right? Now let's find some elements within the array. Okay, so we are going to do the search. I'm going to take the same example. So in the previous video we have declared fruits, and within the fruits array we have declared 6 values, right? Now I'm going to find a value from my array. Okay, so let's say that we want to find this mango. Okay, so we are going to find this mango. So for that we have an inbuilt function which is nothing but find. Okay, so I'm going to call that fruits dot find, and here it's need a predicate. Now predicate is very simple. It is going to find each and every element within the array, and if whatever we are going to search, if the value has been matched, it is going to return as true. Now when it's return a true, it doesn't return us actual boolean, rather it will return us the actual value. Okay, so that is what predicate is. So we know that within our fruits it is going to take one fruit at a time, and then it is going to do the comparison, right? So I'm going to take a fruit here, one fruit at a time, and the arrow syntax. So obviously you might have understand this, we are handling with the callback function here, right? And here I'm going to say if my fruit, okay, so if my fruit is equals to, okay, so because this is string, I have to use the triple equals, right? Now here I'm going to say mango. Okay, now let's store this. Okay, so I'm going to store this. So I can say found equal to, and here I'm going to log this. Okay, so found. So yeah, so we got the output as mango. Cool, right? But I think you are not getting this, right? This looks very awkward to you, right? Let me fix that. Okay, so let me fix that. So here I'm going to write a function here. So what this find is expecting, this guy is expecting a predicate from me, right? Okay, so let's write a predicate function. So here I'm going to say function and predicate, and within the function I have to give a parameter. Okay, because within this fruits I want to pick one fruit at a time, right? So I'm going to pass one fruit here, so fruit. Now I'm going to write a if condition. So what I want to find the mango, right? So here I'm going to write a if condition, and where I'm going to say fruit if it's equals to mango, then I want to return it, right? So within curly braces I can say return true, right? Yes, finished. So let me refresh it again. So here we have a predicate which is going to accept a one fruit at a time, and it is going to do the comparison. If the fruit is equal to mango, then it is going to return boolean. Okay, that is true. Okay, now let me just comment this as of now. Okay, so let me comment, and here I can say let found and equal to fruits dot I have to call the find, right? Now within the find I have to call my function which I have written here. So I'm going to say predicate. Okay, so again we got the same answer, right? But which one looks easy? This one looks easy, right? Only one line. Instead of writing this function and declaring a syntax, if condition and returning value, instead of that we can go with this function here. Okay, so this is very simple. If you remember my function video, I have discussed about this there also, but not this if condition and all. So probably we'll see this in detail in some another video, but I think this is very easy, right? So you have to declare a function where it is going to get a single fruit, that is one fruit at a time, and it is going to do the comparison. If the condition has been matched, then it is going to return the true, but we will not get the boolean as an output, rather we'll get the actual value, that is what we are searching for. Okay, So I hope this makes sense to you, and probably if you do practice, you will get this as well. Okay, fine. Now these things are like pretty much simple in JavaScript, I can say, because in the upcoming videos we are going to use so many times this kind of steps here. So I'm going to use most of the time anonymous function or callback like this. Okay, so get ready for that, and also can just don't watch the video, practice as well. Okay,
fine, let's move.
Dot includes, and within the include I have to pass the search element, that is the string. Okay, so here I'm going to say apple. Now this includes means it is going to return as true. Okay, this is pretty much easy, right? Okay, so if there is a value, matching value, it will return as true. Okay, for example, if I have apples, I do not have anything called apples, right? So it is going to obviously false, right? Yeah. So next one, not this one. So next we have something called indexOf, right? So I'm going to say, let's log this, log fruits dot indexOf, and here I'm going to say which element I'm searching. So I'm searching for the mango, maybe. Okay, so mango, fine. Yeah, so we got the question. Okay, so one, so in zeroth position we have apple, and in the first position we have mango. Okay, index, right? So let's move on to the next one, where we have sort. Okay, so in the beginning we have seen the one scenario, right? So how do we handle the sorting, right? So for that we have two inbuilt methods, which is sort and reverse. Okay, so let me comment this, and here I'm going to say fruits dot sort. Okay, now sort will obviously it is going to reflect in the same array. Okay, that means when we are going to do the sort, it is going to change the actual fruits array itself. Okay, so if I log this now, we'll get the sorted values. Okay, see here we are getting apple, banana, cherry, grape, mango and pineapple, whereas my actual is different, right? So whenever we are going to do the sorting, it is going to change your actual, that is original array itself. Okay, so be cautious about that. If you don't want to change your actual fruits, I mean actual array, probably you can take a clone or copy of that. Okay, now I don't want to get in this order, rather I want to get in the reverse order, that is in the descending order. Okay, so for that we have to use fruits dot reverse. Okay, fine. If I log this now, I will get this as reversed order, that is in descending, right? So here I'm getting pineapple, mango, grape, cherry, banana and apple. Okay, so this is pretty much easy. That is case what we have seen in the beginning of the video, we will take that in our protractor video as well. So at that point I will show you how to use this array concept and our protractor API to complete our test case. Okay, I'm going to declare numbers here. So let numbers, and here I'm going to say maybe 4, 3 and 1 and 0. Fine. Yes. Now so here I'm going to say one number at a time, right? So it is going to give me one number, and then it is going to index of the number, right? I mean index of the array. Okay, now here I'm going to use the arrow syntax or fat arrow. So this arrow syntax is also known as fat arrow. Okay, so here I'm going to log this, so log num. Okay, so you can see we are getting the same exact output, right? And here also we can print the index as well, so it will give you like what in what value it is in what index. Okay, in which portion which value is there. Okay, now the advantage of map is map doesn't going to affect our original array. Okay, for example in the sort, right, in the sort method, while using the sort method, if you have noticed, if you have noticed, it is actually changing our original value, right? Original array, right? But when we are going to do the mapping, it is not going to affect the actual map, I mean actual array. Okay, it is going to return as a new array. Okay, so here I can say let maybe new numbers. Okay, yes, so it has returned as new numbers here. Now I can print that, so I'm going to print that. So log, and here I'm going to say new numbers. Now obviously I will get undefined. Why? Because this method, okay, this sum map, it's not returning anything, right? We are just printing within this, we are not returning. So what we have to do, obviously we have to return this, right? So as of now I'm going to return this num. So one name, one number at a time from my numbers, which is going to give us new numbers as an array. Now if you see, it's going to be new array, right? Now it seems like for each to you, right? No benefits, right? No, that is not the actual case. So here what can I do is I can change it, I mean I can return the value, I can do some manipulation and then I can give. For example, here we are getting 4, 3, 1, and 0, right? So whatever the value I'm getting from my source, I want to add 2 to it. So that means I'm going to add 2 to the original value and then I'm going to return this. Simple, right? Let me plus 2. Okay, so now if you see, this value has been changed to 6, 5, 3, and 2. So obviously you can do the math, right? So that is the use of map. It will return us a new array without affecting the existing, and also it allows us to change the value, that means to manipulate the value. Now let's move to the next one, which is nothing but filter, right? So filter is also very same, but similar to map I can say, but it is going to work based on a conditional statement. So whenever there is going to be true condition, it is going to return the value. Okay, for example, let me comment this. Okay, so I'm going to, or else we'll take this new numbers. Okay, so new numbers dot filter, I'm going to filter this one. Okay, now in the filter also, like same similar to map, it needs two value. So one is the actual value and another one is the index. Okay, now here I'm going to do some filter. Okay, so probably we can say the value which are lesser than 4, we want that value. Okay, so the actual value is 6, 5, 3, and 2, right? So the expected output is 3 and 2, right? So here I'm going to say return, maybe I can say if the value is lesser than 4. Okay, now let's print this. So obviously filter is also going to return us new number, a new array, right? So I can again store, so let filtered, so I'm going to name this as filtered, and here I'm going to log this. Okay, so log, and here I can say filtered, right? So we got the output as 3 and 2, right? It's very easy, right? So here we are going to do the filter. In the filter function, it needs a callback where it needs two argument, one is the value and another one is the index. Now index is optional, even without that also it should work fine, nothing wrong about it. Okay, and then it is going to return us value which is lesser than 4. So in our original array we have 6, 5, 3, 2, so 3 and 2 are the expected, so we got the output, right? But still this looks clumsy to me, right? It has two lines, why we have to write so much things? We can do this in very simple manner as well. Okay, so I'm going to remove this bracket and this bracket here, and here I'm going to remove this as well, and I'm going to take this to the up. Okay, so here I can say and also this return guy is not needed, I think, so let me delete this. Okay, fine, so we got the answer, right? So let me remove this as well. So we got the answer, right? So very simple. So if you have seen here this predicate, right? So we have returned a function, then we have written some boolean condition, I mean if condition, and based on that we are getting the boolean, right? So same things applies for filter as well. So instead of writing like this, we can do it in one line. So however you feel comfort, you can use that, nothing wrong about it. Okay,
okay, so now the next one is reduce. I can say reduce function is very similar to your filter, but
when we do the filtration, that means when we use the filter function, it is going to return us all the matching values, right? But when we use the filter, I mean, when we use the reduce, it is going to give a single output. Let's take this filtered one, okay? So here I'm going to say filtered, and here I'm going to do the reduce. And in the reduce, obviously, it's again, it's a callback, and it's a previous value as well as current value, okay? So within brackets, I can say previous, and here I can say current value, okay? Now, again, I'm going to use the fat arrow, and here what I'm going to do is I'm going to return maybe, okay? So I can return, and here I'm going to say previous plus current, okay? So previous plus current, okay? Now let me store this. Whatever the answer we are getting, we are going to store this, okay? So I can say reduced maybe, and here I'm going to log this. So log reduce, okay? So we got the answer as 5, because obviously previous plus current, so we have only two values, right? So 3 plus 2, it's 5, okay? But it's always need a accumulator as well, okay? So here if I say 0, it is not going to affect our output, because 3 plus 2 plus 0 is obviously 5. But let's say that we have 10 here, so it is going to change the value as 15, okay? So I hope you have learned all the methods in arrays, okay? So, and please do not worry about this callback function as of now. In the next video, I will also tell you what is the use of callback function and how to write a callback function, okay? We know that we can declare an array using this square bracket, right? But also we have another type, which is, I can say let a equal to, I can call the constructor here, and in the constructor you have to pass what is the length of the array. So here I can say maybe 5, okay? And if I log the a value, so I will get empty array with 5 empty spaces, right? So we do not have anything. Now how do we fill the value? So obviously we have to use the push, right? But that is not the case here. So if I do push here, it is going to again last, right? So if I log this now, you can see even though we have declared the size, but still we can expand our array, okay? So that is possible in JavaScript, but whereas in Java, that is not possible, right? So here whenever we are going to do the push thing, it is going to push in the last. So how do we push in this one? So if I want to push in the zeroth position, you can use something like a of 0. So that is, we are calling the index of the array, okay? So in the zeroth position, you can set the value here. So here I can say 5, okay? Similarly, you can call all the things, okay? So here I can say a of 2 equal to 7, something, some value and some index. So based on that, it is going to change, okay? So we can declare array using the square bracket, and using the separate comma separator, you can declare the value. Whereas we can also use the constructor, and here we can specify the size, okay? So that's it from my side. I think it's a long video, I believe. So it's very easy. Arrays concept are very easy. And I also said like why we have to learn arrays, okay? So stay focused on this, and please do practice. So maybe I can come up with some practice to do practice and give you some interview questions as well in the upcoming videos. Okay, so fine, that's it. I hope you have enjoyed the video and you have learned. So do let me know in the comment if you have any specific doubt, okay? So thanks guys, thanks for being here, thanks for watching.